वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि सम प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। गुरवे सर्वलोकानां विषजे भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवत्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं योगीन् गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तावलकं च शिष्यं तं तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यम् केशवं बादरायनं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करम्। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Can repeat. Divyo hyamurtah purushah.
Divyo hyamurtah purushah.
Sabhagya bhyantaro hyajah.
Sabhagya
bhyantaro hyajah.
Aprano hyamana shubrah. क्षरात् परतः परः एतस्माज्जायते प्राणः
एतस्माज्जायते
प्राणः
मनस्सर्वेन्द्रियाणि च
मनस्सर्वेन्द्रियाणि च
वायोर्ज्योतिरापः
वायुर्ज्योतिरापः
पृथिवी विश्वस्य धारिणी अग्नेर्मूर्धा चक्षुषी चंद्रसूर्यौ दिशश्रोत्रे वाग्विवृताश्च वेदाः वायुः प्राणो हृदयं विश्वमस्य अद्यां पृथिवी ह्येष सर्वभूतान्तरात्मा This mantra, fourth mantra, we have seen, starting from the first mantra, यथा सुदीप्तात् पावकात् स्फुलिङ्गः इति तद् ब्रह्म इस् दि जगत् कारणम् दिस् जगत् इस् कार्यम् टु शो दट् द कार्यं डु नाट् एक्सिस्ट् अपार्ट् फ्रम् द कास् दृष्टान्त पावक दृष्टान्त वास् गिवन् Then the Swarupa Lakshanam Divyo Yamurutav Purushaha Iti The Brahma without any attributes, Nirgunam Brahma was talked about. Then from that Aksharam Brahma Hiranyagarbha That is Samashti, Sukshma Shariram was born. Etasma Jayate Pranaha Iti. Prana stands for the Sukshma Shariram. And from that, Hiranyagarbha, Samashti, Stula Sharira Abhimani was born. And the Hiranyagarbha, the Virat. From the Hiranyagarbha, this Virat Purusha was born, and that Virat Purusha, the Virat Samashti, Stula Sharira, Abhimani, is described in this mantra, fourth mantra, which we saw in the last class, Agnihi Murdha Chakshushi Iti. So, Akshara Parabrahmanaha, उत्पन्नस्य अस्य जगतः मूर्धा शिरः उत्तमांगं शिरः अग्निः दट इज द्युलोकः वशकर गेव द मीनिंग ऑफ अग्नि एज द्युलोकः टेकिंग द सपोर्ट फ्रॉम द चांदोग्य श्रुति वाक्य एंड दिस चक्षुषी चंद्र सूर्य द चंद्र एंड सूर्य आर द Netra Sthani Yau, they are comparable to the Netra of this Virat Purusha. And this Disha, Dasha Disha, Dishaha, the 10 directions, they are the Shrotre, Shrotrendriya Sthani, Sthani Ye. They are comparable to the Shrotra of this Virat Purusha. This Chatvaraha, Vedaha. They are vāk vivṛtāha, vāk vyāpāraha, vāni asya, virāt purushasya. Then this vāyuhu, prānaha, prānastāni. Vāyuhu is this prana staniyaha dehadharaka staniyaha pranaha iti. And this sarvam jagat asya virat purushasya hrudayam. Hrudayam dehantaravarti that hrudayastaniyaha. Hrudayastaniyam iti. Padbhyam prithvi, and the prithvi is asya virat purushasya ishvarasya bhagavataha padastaniya asya this prithvi padastaniya comparable to the prithvi the feet of the Lord Bhagavan and that Bhagavan alone is sarva bhutantaratma sarveshu pranishu sarveshu pranishu sarvesham praninam bhutanam praninam antaratma therefore is the drashta is a shrota is the manta is the vijnata is a seer is a listener is a thinker and he is a knower everything is he there is nothing other than the Lord. So, therefore, this jagat is sakshat ishvaraha eva ishvarat abhinnaha, Bhagavan alone. And this Bhagavan alone residing in the hearts of all the beings. He alone is the seer. Vashikara says, Drashta, Sahi Sarva Bhuteshu, Drashta Bhavati, Shrota Bhavati, Manta Bhavati, Vijnata Bhavati, Sarva Karanatma, Sarva Karanatma, as the Sarva Karana, as the instrument, through him only, the seeing, the hearing, the thinking, the knowing, everything is possible. He is a thinker. The thinker Lord is taken to be the thinker, the Lord is taken to be myself as this Ajnani Jiva. It is Bhagavan. The thinker, the seer, the knower, it is Bhagavan. But it is made conditional by a conditional, it is made limited. It is confined to this person, this jiva, limited by this body, mind, senses, and therefore assumes, superimposes kartrutvam on this Ishvara, all pervading this Ishvara. So therefore, that is what is ajnanam. In fact, Bhagavan alone, through all the beings, he sees his srishti. He listens, he thinks, he knows. So, Bhagavan is a basis. He is a basis of sarva prani, sarva prani nam, sarva bhutanam prani nam, drashta bhavati, shrota bhavati, manta bhavati iti. So therefore, what is there is only this Purusha, Bhagavan alone. And this Purusha is Satyam. And this Purusha is Satyam. And there is nothing other than this Purusha. And the Upadhi is Mithya. Upadhi is Mithya, this Purusha is Satya. So therefore, this Virat, which has come from the Maya Sagita Brahma, and that is not separate from the Lord. When we say Virat is Ishvara, then what about the beings in the cycle through which the Jiva undergoes? What it is? It is also within this Purusha, the Ishvara alone. This also Ishvara alone. So that is what the next mantra is going to say. the jiva which undergoes this cycle of this coming and going. All these jivas, they are born from this Ishvara alone. And there is, and this is, this cycle, the cycle of this jiva utpatti and jiva again dissolution, that maranam, it is looked upon as, yeah, it's looked upon as an upasana, as an upasana. Upasana is, that is the karma which is done, the karma which is done literally in a yagyashala, yagyashala having a homakunda into which the ahuti, the oblations are offered, and the karma is performed for a specific reason, a specific ritual for a specific reason, which involves the agni and all the other ingredients required for the ritual, which are offered into the agni, like dhrutam, kashtadi, etc. So offered into the ahuti. The agni is there, and into the agni it is offered. Agni, which is physically seen, and it, and which is invoked, which is into which the devata is invoked, and it is offered. That karma now, without agni, without omakunda, without all the ingredients, if you do the same thing, then it is called upasana. It becomes upasana. And there is upasana called Panchagni Vidya. There is upasana with the name Panchagni Vidya. This Panchagni Vidya is talked about in the Chandogya Upanishad, also in other Upanishad also. This Panchagni Vidya is talked about. Pancha Agni. The name itself suggests Pancha Agni means five Agni. Five Agnis are involved. It can refer to either the locus, the location, Pancha Agni, like the fire which is in the Homakunda, or it can refer to the upadhi which the jiva assumes. Which the jiva assumes. Since this is a upasana, so we can look upon the agni as the upadhi of the jiva, which is born in the virat, from the virat, undergoes different stages, assuming different upadhi. That upadhi can be looked upon as agni, or the locus, the plane in which the jiva is, that also can be looked upon as agni. Since it is the upasana, therefore there is a adhyaropa. There is an adhyaropa. That adhyaropa, the superimposition is deliberate. When the superimposition is deliberate, that is called upasana. When the superimposition is deliberately done, that is called upasana. Like Shalagrame Vishnu Darshanam, that is upasana. Linge Shiva Darshanam, upasana. In the Shalagrama, you invoke Vishnu and worship the Shalagrama. Similarly, in the Linga, it's just a stone, but you invoke Shiva in it, then it becomes an object of worship. The all-pervading Lord is invoked in this small linga. That is upasana. Atasmin tad buddhihi. You perceive, you recognize, you appreciate this linga as a lord, all pervading lord. This is a deliberate superimposition that is called upasana. This is different from the superimposition that you see the rope as a snake. That is not deliberately done. That is done because of the jnana. So there is a difference between upasana and the mistake. Upasana is not a mistake. Upasana is deliberately done. So here the panchagni. The panchagni upasana is mentioned by the Bhashyakara in the introduction. We will read the Sangati and we'll further talk about what is this Agni, Panchagni. We will read the Sangati now. Panchagni dvara cha yaha samsaranti.
Panchagni dvara cha yaha samsaranti.
Prajaha.
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 Taha api.
Taha api.
Taha api.
Tasmadeva purushat.
Tasmadeva purushat.
Tasmadeva purushat.
Prajayante.
Prajayante.
Ityuchyate.
Ityuchyate.
Prajayante. Taha prajayante. Prajaha prajayante. Taha prajaha prajayante. Prajaha means the people, jivaha. Jivaha prajayante. Yaha samsaranti, taha prajaha. Yaha prajaha samsaranti. Yaha prajaha, yaha jivaha samsaranti, taha jivaha. Ye jivaha, not yaha. Jiva is pulling. Ye jivaha samsaranti. Te jivaha prajayante. Jayante, prajayante, prakarshena jayante. So those jivas which undergoes, which samsaranti, samyak saranti in the samsara chakra, samyak saranti, which undergoes, which passes through this cycle, te tasmat eva purusha, tasmat purushat prajayante. Tasmat purushat eva prajayante. They purusha, from this purusha alone. What is that purusha? Tasmat purushat eva prajayante. From this purusha alone, it is born. That purusha, what is referred to in the fourth, in the second mantra, the purusha. The second mantra, the purusha is mentioned from the purusha alone. Jayante. Have we not completed the Bhashyam of the fourth mantra?
Yes, the halfway we are.
Halfway.
Yeah.
Up to which line? I think we did.
Up to Vayu. Prana. Yes, yeah.
To Vayu. I just saw your message now. Yeah, we've not done this. If you have not done, I will do. Okay. Can anyone confirm again, please? Have we done that?
Not sure, Ji.
Okay. Anyway, I will do this, continue. Then we will see. Okay. Because I remember some vaguely, I don't know. I'm not sure also. Okay. I started this, let me do this, and then we'll complete the fourth. Okay. We'll do it. So this tasmat purushat, that aksharat purushat, that is from the Brahma alone. From Brahma alone, this prajaha prajayante. Katam prajayante panchagni dvara. So panchagni. Now the panchagni, we will see what panchagni is. So pancha agnayaha panchanam agninam samaharaha panchagni. Pancha panchagnihi eva dvaraha panchagni dvara. So through the panchagni, through this pancha agni, five-fold fires, through the five-fold fires. What are this? What is this through five-fold fires? We'll see. We are discussing the topic of creation. Srishti is being talked about. From Aksharam Brahma, everything is born. So when you're talking about the Srishti, Upanishad wants to cover everything, including the Janma of this Jiva. All the living, all the beings are born from this Brahma. And this Jivaha, the beings, what happens to them? Because of their Punya Karma, because of that Punya Karma, this Jiva goes to different lokas. And here, the Jivas which have gone to Dyuloka, Swargaloka, can take it as the Loka, Swargaloka, the Jiva which has gone. From Swargaloka, Kshine Punye Kimbhavati, Matyalokam Mishanti. After exhausting the Punya, the Jiva has to come down, again take Manushya Shariram, and again do karma, gaining karma pala, depending on the karma, it goes to different lokas, or again, or take Manushya Janma, or any Janma, starting from small insect to Manushya Janma, all this is the cycle. Now, this Jiva, how does it come? How does it come from Dyuloka to this Bhuloka? How does it enter the human being? How it is born? It is being talked about and it is looked upon as a meditation, a upasana. It is presented as an upasana. We use the word panchagni vidya. Vidya means here it is upasana. Panchagni vidya, this vidya which is mentioned in Chandogya, that the word vidya means it is not knowledge, it is not jnanam, it is upasana. You have to note that the word vidya, it is used in some places meaning upasana. Vidya, the word is derived from the vididhatu, means jnanam. But it is not this meaning jnanam in all the places. Depending on the context, the word vidya have to be interpreted. So panchagni vidya, when we say it is upasana, vidya is upasana. In the Ishavasya Upanishad, which is in Shukla Yajurveda, the mantras, the later portion of the Upanishad, that is, it's one of the small Upanishad. It's got only 18 mantras. After the ninth mantra onwards, up to the eighth mantra only this Brahma Vidya talked about. From ninth mantra onwards, it talks about the karma and it talks about the upasana. And in the ninth mantra itself, the word vidya is used. Andantam of pravishanti ye vidya upasate tato bhuya ivate tamo yavu vidyaya agum rathaha. Here the vidya means what? Antam tamaha pravishanti. Tamaha pravishanti ye tamaha pravishanti vidyam upasate. Those who vidyam upasate, they enter into tamas. Tamas is ajnanam, darkness. Here the word vidya is knowledge. Is it knowledge? No. Here the word is vidya is upasana, or it can be sometimes karma also. So here vidya is not jnanam, not knowledge. Similarly, the word vidya is used in the other places also. Vidyaya amritam ashnute avidyaya mrityum dhirtva vidyaya amritam ashnute vidyaya amritam ashnute vidyaya mrityum dhirtva vidyaya amritam ashnute. One gains amritam by avidya, by vidya, not avidya, by vidya. By vidya, how one gains amritam? There also the vidya have to be interpreted properly. That amritam, when you say vidya, when you give the meaning of the word vidya as upasana and amritam ashnute, that amritam is apekshika amritatva. If the vidya is given the meaning knowledge, then the amritatvam is atyantika amritatvam, that is moksha. So the meaning of the word vidya, depending on the context, to be interpreted, which Bhashyakara does. Without Bhashyakara's support, we cannot know the meaning. So here Panchagni Vidya is, here Vidya is used in the sense of Upasana. So Vidya can mean Brahmajnanam in some place. The word Vidya can mean Upasana in some place, sometimes Karma also. Aham Brahma Asmi. Is it jnanam or upasana? Some people take it as upasana. Aham brahmasmi iti upasate. If you take the meaning of the word vidya as upasana. Atasmin tad buddhihi. It is a deliberate superimposition on me. You have to do the adhyaropanam as brahma. If you take the meaning of the word vidya as upasana. But that is not upasana, that is this truth, that is satya, that is knowledge. So, therefore, agam brahma asmi, this upasana to be done along with karma. Some people, they interpret this agam brahma asmi, the vakyam, it's not mahavakyam, it is for meant for upasana. And it has to be done with the karma. With it. So, therefore, this confusion is possible if we don't understand the meaning of the word upasana. If you don't understand the meaning of the word vidya, vidya as upasana. Now, here, coming back to this topic, here, Panchagni Upasana. Panchagni is five-fold fires. Either the locus, the place where this jiva gets transformed into, that can be looked upon as the Agni, the fire, or that into which the jiva is offered, or the transformation takes place, or the upadhi which the jiva takes, that also can be looked upon as Agni. So therefore, the fivefold upadhi, or the fivefold locations, the places are called Pancha Agni, Pancha Agni. The first locus, the place is Dyuloka. Dyuloka is heaven, Svarga Loka. Now the Jiva went there. Katam, by Punya, the Jiva went to the Svarga Loka. There, having gone to the Svarga Loka, there it has a different upadhi, different sharira. Dyuloka, it gets a different shariram. It gets the shariram Soma Upadhi. Soma Upadhi. Soma is Chandra. Soma is not the Soma juice. Soma Rasa. Soma is Chandra. Chandra Sadrisha Shariram. It gets a body like that of a moon. That it is shining, shining body. Soma Upadhi. About Soma Upadhi and all talks about, it is talked about in the Brahma Sutra. So, the Jiva assumes the Soma Upadhi. So, in that is Dyuloka. So, Dyuloka is one Agni. And Upadhi, what the Jiva assumes is Soma Upadhi. Then from the Dyuloka, after the exhaustion of Punyam, then the Jiva comes to Parjanya. Parjanya is the clouds. When the karma, when the Punya karma of Jiva is over, now the Jiva drops the Soma Upadhi and assumes the Vrishti Upadhi, Vrishti Rupa Upadhi. Parjanya means clouds. So, the Jiva assumes the Upadhi of Vrishti, rain. Clouds are the source of rainwater. So, it comes down to the clouds. All these are Upasana. All these are Upasana. So, the Jiva is offered into the Parjanya. It is like a ritual. First, the Jivas are offered into Dyuloka. Now, the Jivas are offered into Parjanya. In the Dyuloka, it assumes a Soma Upadhi. At the level of this Parjanya, it assumes this, the Upadhi, the Jala Upadhi. And from the clouds, the rain, as rain, they come down to earth. The cloud, from the clouds, the rainwater falls on the prithvi. So Jiva comes down to the earth. So Jiva, now it is offered into the prithvi. Prithvi is the third Agni into which this Jiva is offered, and the Jiva assumes the shariram. What shariram? Here, the Jiva, when along with water falls into the prithvi, it becomes Oshadi shariram. Oshadi annam. Anna Upadhi, it gains. Because of rainwater only, in the prithvi, the annam, the food grows. The food in the form of plants, etc., they grows. So Jiva is offered into this annam, and Jiva assumes Anna Upadhi. And this annam, the Jiva who is has assumed the Anna Upadhi, now it is eaten by the Purusha. Purusha means a person, male person. It is eaten by a male. Now this Anna Jiva, this Jiva through this annam enters into the Purusha Shariram, male body. In the male body, it is in the form of retas. It is in the form of seed. It is in the form of seminal fluid. That is transferred into the mother's body. It is offered as an agouti into the mother's body. From that, the Jiva is born. So, this is called Panchatmi. That is, the Jiva first, it comes down from Dyuloka into Parjanya, from Parjanya to Prithvi, and from Prithvi it enters into Puman, the male body, male shariram, Pum Sharira, from then into the Stri Sharira. So therefore, this is Upasana. That Dyuloka is looked upon as Agni, from that it comes to Parjanya, the clouds is looked upon as Agni. Then Prithvi, that is looked upon as Agni. Then the Purusha, that Puman is looked upon as Agni. Then when it is offered into the female body, that is looked upon as the fifth Agni. So five Agnis. So the five again, the jiva is transformed at five levels, at five lokas, five locations, assuming a different upadhi. In the jivloka, the jiva having a soma sharira, and in the, that is chandra shariram, and in the when it is offered into the clouds, when it comes to the clouds, it offers jala shariram, then oshadi shariram, then it becomes the retas, then the retas is enters into the female, then it becomes, it is born, the jiva is born. So this is called panchagni vidya. This is meant for meditation. It is looked upon as a ritual. As a ritual physically done in a yakshala. This ritual, this is looked upon as a ritual and meditated upon. It is meditated upon. So the jiva therefore undergoes all these changes of assuming different sharira. Soma sharira, vrishti sharira, reta sharira, anna sharira, then enters into the female, iti, different shariram it gains. Now all these are born from what? Born from aksharam brahma eva, from that Ishvara alone. Therefore panchagni dwarena ya prajaha samsaranti, these jivas, they travel. Those, they are born from this Purusha alone. The Purusha is this Brahma alone, this Aksharam Brahma alone, this jivas are born. So this cycle of jiva is looked upon as panchagni. So that is the significance of the word panchagni. So panchagni dwara. Tasmat from that Purusha. From that Purusha, what Purusha? From that Purusha, the Purusha which is Apranaha, Amanaha, Shubraha, Divyo Yamurtav Purushaha, that Purusha, Aksharam Brahma. From that alone everything has come. Hiranyagarbha has come, Virata has come, and this Jivas also have come. They are not separate from that Purusha. They are not separated from that Purusha. So that is what is being talked about here. So what the Shruti wants to say is this Virat, Virat is a karya product, which is born from the Karanam Brahma, not separate from the Karanam. And within the Virat, this Jiva, which undergoing all this cycle, that is not different from this Brahma Ishvara. So that is the tatparyam. So that is the details of the creations are not important, but the tatparyam is important. The tatparyam is everything is Ishvara. And the Shuddhi elaborates the Srishti Prakaranam in detail. In the last three mantras, it is elaborated. Now we will read the mantra. I think we have read the mantra also. Now, Tasmad Agnihi Samidaha Yasya Suryaha. Tasmad Agnihi Samidaha Yasya Suryaha Somad Parjanyaha Oshadayaha Prithivya. Kasmad Purushat. Agnihi, you have to supply Jayate. Agnihi Jayate. Purushat Agnihi Jayate. Here Agnihi is Dyuloka, as we saw in the previous mantra, Bhashyakara said, Agnir Murda, that Agni is Dyuloka. So, Tasmat Agnihi Jayate. Yasya Samidaha Suryaha. That is the first line. Tasmat Agnihi Jayate. Yasya Suryaha. Yasya Samidaha Suryaha. So, Agnihi Jayate. That is Dyuloka. Agni in the form of Dyuloka is born. Born from what? Born from this Purusha. For that, Samidaha. Samidaha is Samit, fuel. The fuel is the sun. So this Dyuloka is born for which the son is the refugial. Dyuloka born from what? From the Purusha. Tasmad referring to the Purusha, that Akshara Brahmanaha Paramatmanaha. In this Dyuloka is born. Dyuloka is one Agni, and that is born for which the Indanam, the fuel, is Suryaha, the fire. Agni becomes bright by the fuel. Similarly, by sun, this Dyuloka becomes Prakashaha. So this Dyuloka is lighted up by Surya, which is the Samidaha, which is the Indanam. Then Somat Parjanyaha Oshad, Somat Parjanyaha Oshadayaha Pratibhyam. Somat Parjanyaha, that is one. Somat Parjanyaha Jayate. Now Somat, Somat is from the Soma. Soma is moon. Where is the moon? Moon, that is this Jiva, which has assumed this Soma Shariram in the Dyuloka. That which is born in Dyuloka, that is called Soma. From Somat, Parjanyaha Jayate. This Vrishti, Parjanya is Vrishti, this rain. Rain is born. That is, Jiva is converted to rain. That is, from the Chandra Shariram, from the Soma Upadhi, now it gains the Vrishti Upadhi, Vrishti Shariram. It gains the Vrishti Shariram. So this is now, this is the second stage. First stage is in Dyuloka. Second stage it gains a Shariram of Vrishti, Vrishti Shariram. This is second, Vrishti, the clouds. Then Oshadayaha Prithivyam, the clouds becomes rain and it comes down to earth. The rain water, when it falls on the earth, it becomes Oshadi, the plants. Therefore, Oshadayaha Prithivyam Oshadayaha Jayante. Oshadayaha Jayante. Plants are born. Where? Prithivyam. Oshadayaha Sambhavanti Prithivyam. Prithivyam, Bhumyam. In the Prithivi, the Bhumi, the Oshadis are born. The plants are born. So Prithivi is the third Agni. Is the third Agni. And Oshadi, it transforms into Oshadi. This Oshadis are eaten by human beings, Puman. That eating, that is Aguti. This Oshadi has offered. This Oshadi, which are nothing but Annam. Oshadis are Annam. In fact, Annam, this, when we say Annam, it is Oshadi. Plants are Oshadi, which is offered into the Agni Kunda. What is that Agni Kunda? This human beings, into male body, into the male Shariram, it is offered. So this Oshadis, these plants are eaten by Puman. Aguti is done into the Pum Sharira. And Aguti, in the form of Annam, it is offered into the Pum Sharira. And that is what we do when we eat food, bhojanam, we do parisheshanam. We don't just take the food, we do the parisheshanam and offer the food, saying pranaya swaha, apanaya swaha, vyanaya swaha, danaya swaha, sananaya swaha, brahmane swaha iti. Even when we offer to Bhagavan Nivedyam, we say this. We say this and offer the food. Swaha, the word we use only when we offer something into the Agni. Into the Agni, in the Agni Kunda. In the ritual, in the Yaga Yajna, you would have seen Swaha. When you say Swaha, you offer the Gritam or any other like Annam, etc., it is offered into the Agni when the word Swaha is uttered. And this is the Yajna. this eating is a yajna. Eating is also yajna. That is why Brahmarpanam Brahma Abhigi. Brahma Agnav Brahmanahutam. Brahma Ivatena Gantavyam Brahma Karma Samadhina. It is that eating is a ritual. You are offering annam into the Vaishvanara Agni, which is there in the stomach. Agam Vaishvanaro Bhutva Praninam Degamashitaha. Bhagavan says in the Gita, the 15th chapter, Vaishvanara Agni, Agnim Bhutva, Agnihi Bhutva. I alone, it is there in the all the beings. So to that Vaishvanara Agni, you are offering. This is a offering. This is a ritual, a sacrifice. Therefore, it is one Agni. Agni means this karma, this Agni karma. Here it is Upasana, therefore it's all visualization. So this Agudi is offered into the Pum Shariram. There it becomes Retas. Therefore, now Retas, it has become Retas. Now this Retaha Puman Retaha Sinchati Shichdatu. Shichdatu means, shich means to sprinkle. Abhisheshanam, parisheshanam, abhisheka, all these are from this dhatu only. Shichdatu. Shichdatu, which takes numagama, therefore becomes sinchati, sinchataha, sinchanti. We have seen shichdatu. Causative form is sechayati. So, puman, sinchati. Retaha, sinchati. Reta is karma, dvitiya vibhakti. So, puman, Retaha Sinchati Kutra Yoshita Yam. This Purusha, he places this Retas, the seed, the Bija, the seminal fluid into Yoshita. Yoshita Yam. Yoshita is Strilinga, female body. Into the female body, he places, he offers as a, it's an Agni. So it is the fifth locus. And there the seed is converted into the Purusha. There the seed is converted. Purusha is the Jiva, the body, a child body. It is born. So in this, Bhavi Prajaha Purushat Samprasutaha Samyak Prasutaha Prasavam Bhavatya Prasutaha. All these creations are born. Prajaha Samprasutaha. The creatures are born from what? Purushat. How many? Bakrihi. Bakrihi. Bakrihi is Chandasa. Srilinga should be Bakhvayaha. Srilinga. Bakri is the Pratipadikam. Nadi Pratipadikam. Nadi Nadyo Nadyaha. Bakhvayaha it must be. But here Bakrihi Chandasa Prayoga. Chandasa. So Shruti says Bakrihi. Bakrihi is equal to Bakhvayaha. Akhayaha Prajaha means many. Prajaha, the jivas, creatures. Purushat, Asmat Purusha, Asmat connect. The Purusha from the Purusha alone, it, all these are born. Purusha is Aksharam Brahma. From Aksharam Brahma, all these are born, undergoing these five stages, five Agni. All these are born from the Aksharam Brahma Eva. Everything is born of this Aksharam Brahma. This is the meaning of this, the mantra, the Vashyam up to this mantra. We will see later. The next class we will see. Before we do that, the fourth mantra.
Shamitamji, we have done fully fourth one. I checked. I have written Sa is a last line, meaning is there in my notebook.
So, have we completed the fourth one?
Yeah. He is the seer, hearer, mind, okay. Then knower, all karanas.
Okay. So, it means we can continue.
Every word I have written meaning.
Okay. It means we can continue the Bhashan to this.
Yeah.
Very good. So, let us read the Bhashan to the fifth mantra. Tasmad.
Asmat.
Parasmat Purushat.
Parasmat Purushat.
Rajavastana Vishesharupaha. So, tasmat, it is there in the Nirmulam, which is equal to parasmat purushat. Parasmat purushat. What is a parasmat? Paraha, that is parasmat referring to this aksharam brahma. This purusha, that's paramarthika. Para is the paramarthika swarupa. Brahma, brahmanaha, paramatmanaha. So, from that, with maya, without maya, srishti is not possible. So, maya sahita, brahmanaha. That is, from that, purushat, prajavastana vishesha rupaha, agnihi jayat, agnihi jayate. So, agnihi, prajavastana vishesha rupaha. That vishesha rupaha, that is praja avastana. Avastana is the place. Place of what? Praja, the jivas. So, which is in the form of vishesha, the specific form, specific rupa. The form of the specific locus, the place of jiva. What is that? Agnihi. So, praja avastana vishesha rupaha agnihi. Agnihi referring to dyuloka. That is the even Swargaloka. Swargaloka, we say, Swargaloka is higher loka. That loka, it is. From Brahmaloka also, the jiva come down. If this Krama Mukti is supposed to happen, if the person, if the jiva not interested in even in Brahma Vidya, even from Brahmaji, then it is possible. Brahmaloka, again, it has can come down. Brahmaloka, from that Krama Mukti, therefore, Ayur Loka, from above from Ayur Loka, that is Agnihi. The Agni, the word has got the Visheshana, is a qualifier, Prajavastana Vishesha Rupaha. Rupa, that is form, Vishesha is specific or particular, in the form of a particular, what? Avastana. Avastana is the locus, the place. Stana, Avastana. Place of Jivas. So, Prajanam Avastanam. Prajavastanam. Avastanam is avatishtate. Yatra avatishtate iti avastanam. That which resides, that which stays, stadatu. Ava upasarga stadatu. That which stays is called, the place is called avastha. The condition is called avastha. Avatishtate yatra avastanam. It is adhikarana. Avasthanam, the word is derived from sthadhatu with the lute pratyaya, adhikarana vyutpatti. Avatishtate yatra iti avasthanam, the place where it resides. And the particular place, vishesha rupaha is there, which is dyulokaha, that is agni, that is agnihi. So, prajanam avasthanam, prajavasthanam, prajavasthanam visheshaha prajavasthana, Prajavastana Vishesham. The Prajavastana Vishesham Eva Rupam Yasya Agnehe Saha Agnihi Dyulokaha. That is Samasa. Vigraha for Prajavastana Vishesha Rupaha. Rupa, the word is Apumsakalinga, which is in Pullinga. Qualifying Agni. Agni is Pullinga, therefore Rupa becomes Rupaha. Therefore Bhugubrigi Samasa. Prajana Avastana Prajavastana. That is one samasa, shashti tat purusha samasa. Prajavastanam vishesham, prajavastanam, prajavastana nam, prajavastana nam, vishesham, prajavastana, vishesham, or visheshaha. That prajavastanam vishesham eva rupam. That praja, the place, the particular place of residence of this prajas are the forms of which that is dyuloka agnihi iti. So, prajavastana visheshaṁ eva rūpaṁ yasya agnehe saha agnihi is referred. Therefore, it is dyuloka surgaloka. So, from the purusha, this dyuloka, which is the place of residence of this the jivas dyuloka dyuloka iti agnihi agnihi jayate agnihi jayate dyuloka is born dyuloka is born means the jivas are born in this dyuloka next line saha visishyate
saha visishyate
samidah yasya suryah
samidah yasya suryah
samidah iva samidah
samidah iva samidah
suryena hi dyulokah samidhyate
suryena hi dyulokah samidhyate
so saha visishyate kaha visishyate that agni which is specified in the previous line saha the dyulokah visishyate it is qualified, it is specified it is distinguished how by saying samidaha yasya suryah iti samid is the fuel what is the fuel for dyuloka suryah yasya referring to this dyulokasya agnehe samidaha suryah this dyulokasya samit the fuel which is the cause for lightening up dyuloka is the word dyuloka from the divdhatu div is to shine fourth gana divyati iti devaha devas are shining there shining people and it's upasana therefore here it is Upanishad says the Surya is what makes everything shine so that is the samit that is the fuel for this dyulokaha and dyulokaha is visishyate saying this sun is the samit for this dyuloka samidaha iva samidaha as though a fuel not literally as though it's all upasana meditation visualization as though samidaha iva samidaha suryaha samidaha iva samidaha bhavati yasya this agnehe dyulokasya suryena hi dyulokah samidyate by surya alone this dyuloka is samidyate is prakashyate iti dyuloka is illumined prakashanam bhavati how by this surya which is the indanam dyulokah dyauhu eva lokah dyulokah loka is the place jau who is that loka where the higher loka jau the word jau loka is samasa it has got two words div and loka div is declinable vakarantah strilingah div shabdah jau divau divah div is declinable dyauhu it becomes prathama vibhakti ekavachana so dyauhu eva lokah dyulokah swarga lokah ityartah for which the summit the fuel is suryena samidyate by surya it shines it illumines by it illumines okay I think we can stop there the next time we will see we can reconfirm the whether fourth mantra is done not done we will
yes
okay so please mark it next line is tato hi dyulokat we have to start from that line we'll see that in the next class om purnamadah purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadahya purnamevavashishyate ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ
धन्यवाद गुरुजी
धन्यवाद गुरुजी
धन्यवाद
गुरुजी
धन्यवाद